In this brief video, I want to just take you through as far as typography and web design. Now, this isn't really part of, say, the coding or development of a website, but when you are picking out typefaces or fonts, as sometimes they're called, to be used on a website, what can actually happen here is now you're getting more into the design side, not so much the development. But you may see some terms in your chapter here regarding the typefaces that you might not be familiar with or why we are choosing those terms here. So just a real quick overview for everybody. What is typography? Yes, there are typographers out there. These are the folks that literally, if you've ever used Microsoft Word or any type of word processor program where you're using Times New Roman, Arial, anything like that, those are examples of fonts. So typography overall, the idea behind it in web design is that we are going to combine different types of fonts to make our designs and layouts, you know, pretty but yet usable. And that's always the line you're going to be walking as a web designer and developer, is you want the usability and the organization of the information, but on the flip side, you also want it to be aesthetically pleasing as well to the user. Now, I wanted to include, normally this is more on the graphic design side of things, but I would like to just show you that yes, as far as typefaces and typography go, there is a method to our madness here. As you can see, you've got a ton of different elements whenever you are working with specific typefaces. Now, I want to point out to you, you do not need to memorize these. Fun fact, I'm actually a bit of a type nut, so this type of stuff is really cool to me. The things that I'd like to draw your attention to, though, really in this example here is, like, if you look under typographic here and you look at this I and you see kind of this magenta area, what you will often see in the CSS declarations is whether or not we're using a serif or a sans serif typeface. A serif, when it comes to typography, is the idea of having that small kind of footer on different elements. Like you can actually see on the H next to it, there's another serif on both of these. So what does that mean? To give you just a brief overview here of the different families that you may run into or terms that you may run into when working in web development here, let's start with the serif. So these are, I like to call them the small feet. They're attached to the letter forms. Serif typefaces originate from print, like physical books. The idea of a serif is that it is used to guide the eyes across the lettering. If you think about it, we don't actually read the entirety of the letter when we are reading sentences. We actually kind of glaze across the top of all of the lettering. Like for example, just looking at my title here that I have for families of typefaces, you may not have noticed, but if anything, what you did was you probably, your eyes went across the top of the letterings here. You did not physically or visually look at each individual letter to sound out or create the words used here. So as I also point out down here, so when would you want to use a serif typeface? These are actually phenomenal if you know that something is going to be printed. But actually, they're probably not the best choices when you're working on monitors. Because we are in a pixel-based environment when we are working on the monitors, sometimes as far as the serifs go, they can kind of blend together or they cannot flow reasonably. So, and I give you some examples of typefaces down at the bottom here that are considered to be serif typefaces, which actually brings me to the other option here, sans serif. The sans serif, and this is actually what this main core text that I have in the PowerPoint here is typed in. Notice like the lack of any of the feet on any of the edges of the letters. It is a very straight lined typeface. This is much easier on the eyes when you are designing large amounts of text to be read by somebody on a website. You don't have the issues that you would have as far as the serifs regarding pixel-based layout, and can be much easier, and it also sizes better as far as scalability. So some of the examples here, I included Verdana Ariel. As a fun side fact for all of you, Helvetica is kind of the, for the type purists out there, both in graphic design, print design, but even a bit in web design, Helvetica is the typeface that can do no wrong. So I did include a link here. Actually, if you are interested and you want to go further, there was a, I think it's on Netflix, there is actually an entire documentary on the creation and development of Helvetica. So if you're like, wow, typeface stuff is really neat, check it out. Now, two more here that you might run into. Monospace is a very common one as well. The difference between monospace and, say, serif typefaces, like a Times New Roman, is it while it will have the serifs on each of the letters, what it has, though, is specific same spacing between each letter of a term. So it isn't a matter of you are kind of working between or the spacing changes as far as, you know, the size of the letter. The spacing is equal. We will often see this. You may have seen this, for example, you actually see it in your textbook. This is a very common one in textbooks that we use as, I call it a techie font. We often use it to note the chunks of code. So you actually see it quite frequently in your textbook. Whenever McFadis is talking about things like, you know, I'm looking at page 67 while I'm talking to you about this, where he's showing the CSS and the HTML, those typefaces used in those two areas, that is considered a monospace. I would even guesstimate that that is Courier. The two big names here for monospace, if you're looking specifically for a monospace typeface, are Courier and Courier New. Now, the last one, I kind of tied a whole lot together here. You may see people call it fantasy, but if you watch the next video talking a little bit more in depth about adding, you know, fancy typefaces to your web pages, you'll see that we actually break these out even further into Art Deco, brush scripts, cursive writing, shapes, but it's really fantasy. These are your fun fonts. These are the things that can be kind of silly. If you've ever seen, you know, I use, for example, like the Harry Potter or Star Wars typeface, the Friends typeface, anything like that. Those would be kind of, those would fall under this fantasy element here. You want to use these sparingly. These are great for like a title or to use in a brand identity, but you don't want to be typing mass amounts of text, such as a paragraph or informational paragraphs, in a fantasy typeface. Two that are often included directly on computers that I included here are Impact and Bauhaus 93. And actually, those are two of more of my favorite options. Now, Comics Cursive, again, that's another one here. This one is another one that you gotta be really careful of. I find a lot of folks like the cursive because, oh, yes, it does exactly what it's supposed to do. It looks like, hey, I wrote this. So a lot of people will use this like if they're signing an About Us page or anything like that. You have things like Vivaldi, Comic Sans, Brush Script, Adder are kind of the items here. Now, one thing to warn you about, that I do have a warning there. While Comic Sans actually does have a great use when it comes to dyslexia and reading, from a design standpoint, there are a lot of purist designers out there that both typefaces, Comic Sans and Papyrus, they are extremely overused and a lot of folks will frown upon the use of them. They do have their uses, just be careful of the overuse. Outside of that, just in closing here, I mean, I do have some references from our library. Again, you may need to use your CCAC ID to log in, but when you're thinking about all of these fonts, my best advice to you, especially starting out, think in terms of like header fonts and content fonts. I would go not beyond three fonts in a design. If you are just starting out, stick to two. We have gone beyond the era of having to embed a specific typeface into like a header graphic. So, you know, stick to two typefaces and I think you're going to be fine, and it'll give your website a little bit more life and a little bit more design and make it more aesthetically pleasing on the eyes.